reaction to the Washington Post story that moved today, reporting that investigators from the State Department issued a subpoena to the Bill, Hillary, and Chelsea Clinton Foundation last fall, seeking documents about the charity's projects that may have required approval from the federal government during Clinton's term as Secretary of State. They also reportedly, according to the Washington Post, asked for records related to her top aide, Huma Abedin. What can you tell us about this?
Well, Wolf, I saw that report, but I really can't tell you much more than what's in it. The foundation has been quoted in that story noting that the request that came from the AIG does not concern Hillary Clinton or the foundation. But it's very hard, to be honest with you, for me personally, to keep track of all the fishing expeditions that this IG office has conducted. Remember, Wolf, a couple years ago, this was the same office that launched an investigation into one of Secretary Clinton's top aides over maternity leave. And when the Justice Department refused to go along with that fishing expedition, they had to give it up. And so now, ever since, they've been looking for other things. In the last few weeks, we've seen reports of who works in that office, that State Department IG's office. You have the number two official there, Amelia DeSanto, who's a former eight-year aide to Senator Chuck Grassley, who last month said his number one goal this year is to defeat Hillary Clinton. The number three official in that office, David Seide, we just learned a few weeks ago, conducted a failed prosecution of a former campaign aide to Secretary Clinton back when she was running for Senate in 2000. They took that all the way to trial. The gentleman was acquitted. So you have these individuals that have a history of targeting Hillary Clinton, and strangely, we've seen a pattern of leaks emerging on the eves of primary elections and debates. So I think it's a very troubling phenomenon, and I think it's just more of the same. The voters see through it. And I don't think that it'll actually figure into the voting that's going to happen in the next 6 weeks.
So you say this fishing expedition or whatever you're calling it, that there's a sort of a plot inside the IG, the Inspector General's office at the State Department, to get Hillary Clinton?
All I know is that they have mounted several different fishing expedition style investigations since she decided to run for president. There's no basis to any of them. And I think that it's intended to create headwinds for her campaign. It's not going to work. She is a fighter who has spent decades encountering resistance from those that want to defend the status quo. She keeps fighting for progressive change. I think Democratic voters see through it.
But the Inspector General himself was appointed by the President of the United States, confirmed by a Democratic majority in the Senate. You're not suggesting that the IG himself, maybe other aides in that office, you're accusing them
of doing something wrong.
But go ahead. Tell us what you think about the IG, the Inspector General himself. I think his name is Charles McCullough.
Well, that's the Inspector General for the intelligence community. There's also an Inspector General for the State Department. And it's just a fact, Wolf, that two of the top aides in that office have a background in terms of targeting Hillary Clinton. You see the number two official in that office, a former top aide to Senator Chuck Grassley, worked for him for 8 years. And strangely, coincidentally, Senator Grassley seems to come upon possession of many of the details of the State Department IG's office's reviews. And strangely, just coincidentally, they end up leaking out. So people should draw their own conclusions from that. I think Democratic voters see it as quite transparent.
All right, I just want to be precise, because you're making a serious accusation of about a potential witch hunt inside the Inspector General's office at the State Department. You're not making a similar accusation about the Inspector General for the intelligence community.
There are serious questions that need to be asked about the independence of that office.
Which
and
office?
I think that the Inspector General's office within the State Department, it's gone back to emails, now the foundation, according to this report, and then going back 2 years ago, a fishing expedition into a top staffer's maternity leave. I mean, that was ridiculous, and the Justice Department laughed at it when the State Department IG's office made a referral over there, rightfully so. These were partisan fishing expeditions. You have a number two official there again that worked for 8 years for Senator Chuck Grassley, and it happens to be Senator Grassley that comes upon all the details of these reviews that this office is conducting. And again, 3 weeks ago, you heard him attend a Trump rally and say that his goal is to defeat Hillary Clinton. He's using taxpayer dollars as the chairman of the Senate Judiciary Committee, and then it just so happens to have a top aide working in this same office.
I wrap it up, but I just want to make sure that you're not making a similar